It's a good thing you're so cute because you're so bad.
Yes. Ken and Jane Gremling have been married for 47 years. Throughout that time, as you can imagine, they've faced many of life's challenges. The first among them, getting to the altar.
We dated for like 3 weeks, and she kind of fit the bill.
But Ken got cold feet. Not only was it fast, Jane was much younger and her mother didn't exactly approve. But Jane was committed and she powered through.
I looked at him and I said, well, I hate to tell you, but I'm going to be at Malabar Inn on November 27th. And if you don't show up, then you're going to miss out on the best thing that ever happened to you. And yes. He was there.
I showed up.
Showing up for each other ever since through some of the toughest events life could throw at them. One of those came last year when Ken was diagnosed with breast cancer.
Well, I was taking a shower and I felt, you know, something. I kept bleeding then from my nipple.
Enter Dr. James Abraham, director of the medical oncology program at the Cleveland Clinic.
It's really rare, and it's a really unique situation.
He says the lesson here is that Ken paid attention to his body, noticed some odd symptoms, and took action. Breast cancer overwhelmingly impacts women, but men do get it.
Male breast cancer is really rare. You know, it's 1 in 1,000. The whole country in the U.S., about 2,500 men or so get breast cancer, compared to about 250,000 women getting a diagnosis of breast cancer. So it's a rare phenomenon.
Rarer still is what happened next. Ken had a mastectomy, doctors put him on a pill for treatment, and he's doing well.
He came through it fine, and we thought, well, we dodged that bullet.
Oh, that's nice.
6 months later, Ken was back in Dr. Abraham's exam room for a new diagnosis.
I had had every checkup since I was 30 years old. And that ended up being breast cancer for me.
Same breast, same location, same treatment.
I just figured that I was going to come through it exactly like him because we share everything. But I will say that I think our sharing should be kept to a minimum.
By each other's side in sickness and in health.
I think it's important to have somebody that's a support. You know, I tried to be supportive for Jane when she had it, and she was, you know, right there for me.
Really like it.
I'm here, you know, we're gonna do this together.
I treat about 200 to 250.
Early diagnosis is crucial. Any cancer doctor will stress that. But Dr. Abraham says just as important is finding a team that you trust to treat you. And in this case, that began with a husband helping his wife.
Okay.
And for them, when it happened together, it kind of gives a unique and a family perspective.
The best way to do it.
Really supporting each other. They continue to do that through this difficult journey.
That's nice.